Die druk om te presteer in 'n bedryf wat oor die algemeen beskou word as 'n manlik gedomineerde bedryf, blyk nie alle vroue te intimideer of te benadeel nie. Was daar daadwerklik verandering in die Suid-Afrikaanse rolprentbedryf of is dit nog oorwegend 'n manswêreld wat bloot vroue akkommodeer? Ons was by die onlangse Silverskermfees om te gaan uitvind.
You know, you can't suddenly say after so many hundreds of years of subjugation, which is a reality, that suddenly, you know, we're now in the film industry all equal. We are not. Women need to still support each other. And we don't have enough female directors that are established.
I remember back in 2012, one of the SAFTAs, the Film and Television Awards, there was no award given for Best Lead Actress, because there were no parts written for female leads. And that created a big discussion to say, how can you, in an entire year of making films, not have a single role for a lead actress? It was a real low moment for the industry. And in the years following that, there have been certain initiatives for female writers, female directors to write stories about women, focusing on women's stories, so that never happens again.
Ek wil kan heldinne op 'n skerm sien. Ek wil kan hê dat my dogter heldinne op 'n groot skerm kan sien en as ek vir haar die voorbeeld hopelik kan wees van wat dit is om 'n sterk vrou te wees en sy moet ooit eendag vir my vra maar wat het ma gedoen om in 'n filmbedryf daai verandering te bring en al is dit net op 'n klein skaal, was dit vir my belangrik om so tipe film te kan maak.
Ek dink is die mees opwindende tyd om vrou te wees in hierdie bedryf. Daar's meer geleenthede as ooit tevore vir vrouens. Mense kom besef dat vroue se stemme noodsaaklik is in hierdie bedryf. So as 'n vrou skrywer en as 'n vrou regisseur, dink ek daar's baie plek vir ons. Baie geleenthede. Ek dink net nie daar's genoeg vrouens wat weet dat die deure nou oop is vir ons nie.
Ek dink dit is nog steeds nie waar. Ons is nog steeds nie waar ons moet wees nie. Ek weet ook dat vroue minder betaal word. Dit weet ek vir 'n feit. Ons is nog nie waar ons moet wees nie, maar dit is definitief beter. Ek kry meer interessante rolle hier nowadays. And I see more women involved in our technical crews on film sets and behind the scenes. And that is encouraging.
Daar is ruimte om oor die negatiewe elemente van dit te gesels, maar ek dink definitief moet mens dit nie doen sonder om ook 'n groot lig te skyn op wat wel werk en wat wel positief is op hierdie stadium van waar ons is in 'n gesonde filmbedryf waar daar definitief plek is vir vroue op alle vlakke.
What frustrates me is that a lot of the time what people say is, but the opportunities are there, like it's the time for women to claim their space and step. It's not that simple. It really isn't, because a lot of the gatekeepers are still men and white men that have been in these positions for however many decades.
I'm really glad to see that there are quite a few males in the room as well for them to hear, because as females, we know what we need to do to make environments safe for other females. We know that women need childcare. They need someone to pick up their children. It's great that the men are here to hear that story as well.
In the instances where you find female writers and directors being given opportunities, it's by female producers. So the most prominent male producers are still working with other male writers, directors, etc. So there is a big need for the men to actually understand that they also need to play a part in this. If not, the women will actually take over.
I think across the board and just generally being a woman that is successful, without a doubt, a lot of people are going to think, oh, but who gave her that opportunity, or who gave her that leg up to be where she is now?
Qualities that are admired in men, so to be strong, to be a fierce negotiator, to be hard when you need to be hard, are qualities that men are respected for and we are made to feel ashamed for.
If you are a woman you need to make yourself smaller, you need to not be confrontational, not too assertive, you need to just be a little bit less than what you potentially really are. And I'm not okay with that.
You know that you've got to fight a little bit more just to be heard, you know? I've noticed that. I noticed that sometimes you've got to work a little bit harder for your opinion to matter. It's this thing about being taken seriously. You know, whether it's on the floor, in a technical crew. And sometimes you still notice that men will make inappropriate remarks to a woman on a film set. Definitely.
Women that are not strong and women that are not accomplished and been in the industry for years and years don't necessarily have the power to be able to protect themselves sexually. And that's the reality of our industry.
Sexual harassment has been like big time in the news lately. And I mean, I must say, I was very unaware of it because I've never had an incident on any one of my sets that I've been aware of. But it is something that's raised its head, and I think it's the most awful thing for women to deal with, like really awful, because it puts you in such a compromised position, and it actually makes me incredibly angry. I almost feel that there needs to be some sort of a stance taken by the broadcast and some sort of legal recourse. Like, if it happens on a production, you're out, you're replaced.